So we talked about security planning sort of consists of many different parts. The last one was we talked about controls. Next, we talk about what we call a security policy that you have. So we're talking really about enterprise security policy. You could have policies at national level or something like that. Federal government may have one across its different agencies, and each agency may have its own and things like that. But if you think about this in the context of an enterprise, security planning requires that you have some sort of a security policy. What exactly is a security policy? A security policy really sort of at a high level articulates what our security objectives are. What is that we want to, what goals do we have? We want to maintain confidentiality. You want to make sure that sensitive data is not disclosed to parties that are not authorized to see it. We want our systems to be available. We don't want our data to be corrupted. We don't want sensitive data to get into the hands. We want to be legally compliant or whatever it is. You can think about all kind of sort of objectives somebody might have, which actually motivate what a policy is. So often this high-level articulation requires, it would include some sort of a legal, business, and regulatory rationale for why the policy has what it does. Well, legal and regulatory, you don't really have a lot of choice. Business reasons tell you why it's good for the enterprise or for the company. And what's good for the company, of course, is good for its employees. So that's the articulation of the underlying reasons why we want to have the kind of policy that we do. So the policy really is, what you should do and what should not be done. So we talked about passwords, for example, what kind of password you should choose, what the size, length of a password be, and things like that. We may have web and email policies, for example. Can you surf the web while you're at work? The policy actually might say, if something were to go wrong, if there is some security event that occurs, what sort of response is that we're going to have? Do you need, if your machine gets compromised, do you have to inform somebody, for example? So the security policy or the do's and don'ts, and we saw some examples of those, of course, they may have to do with prevention, so bad things don't happen. They may have to do with detection, so compromise, how you find out that there was a breach, may have to do with how we respond to that sort of a thing and how remediation occurs. And of course, it must address the concerns and impact that could any of these things have. So rationale, articulation of why things need to be the way the policy says they should be. And if it doesn't sort of address the concerns and needs impact it might have on users, of course, the policy may not be well accepted.